Okay, let's talk a little bit about construction planes and curves. It's basically the bread and butter of plasticity and any sort of CAD program. So construction planes are, you've got some that are already kind of set. Your X, Y, and Z coordinates kind of have their own little construction planes kind of set up. So if you go to your right side, this is all construction plane. Same thing with top, bottom. So, you got these here. If you double click, it'll align to it. And even if you drag off, that construction plane is still there. So you can still draw on it. It'll still respect that construction plane. You can also do, you can create a face and it can become a construction plane. So, and be sure you click off of that or it's going to stay on there. Let's go ahead, click on him again, space bar. And see how this works. You can draw anything on there. This is your corner curve or a corner rectangle. You know, and then you can even draw that on there. You know, you can select that, and then extrude out or B new body. So let's go ahead and escape that. Go ahead and get off that construction plane. Get rid of these. Go to the right side here. If you say like you have this set up on the right side, your construction plane is based on that one coordinate, the Y coordinate, and the Z. Just depends on which way you are facing. So if you draw out here, you can see it draws it out there. But in turn, if you draw another one here, you can see it draws it on the face. So that's how you set up these construction planes. So let me get rid of these guys and we'll do something real quick. We'll draw up this guy, the console itself. So let's go ahead and go to the front and zoom out just a little. There we go. And I'm going to turn on grid snapping for now just so I get a similar size. So we're going to do a corner rectangle. And that looks about right. So we left click to confirm our size. And if we like it, we just right click to confirm. And then if you do B on the keyboard, it will bevel the edges, depending on which direction you go. See, this will only give you curved bevels on curves, so you won't get straight lines, chamfers, or whatever you want to call them. So we got our basic shape there. So now we select that face, that temporary face. And then we could pull out. Let me turn off grid snapping. Don't need that anymore. I just wanted to get the basic size. And pull him out there. And we can go ahead and get rid of that little plane, that little curve there. And we could do another one right onto the face. So I could select him, space bar, and then draw another curve. Or, yeah. Another corner rectangle, and see it'll lock on to the center of that radius, which is kind of nice. Right click, B, produce a new one. There we go. Cool. So I probably should have pulled them out a little bit, but that's okay. We'll select that, dig them in. There you go. And then now you got your basic. And turn him off. There's the basic starter shape of that. Other things I like to do. Let's see, let's select this interface here. I like to do, say, like, I like to make this shape. Let me find a spot. Z right there. I always try to align that side to an axis. Helps me out later, and I'll show you why. All right, so select him. We're going to do G, move him up, and then do a Shift D to duplicate. Right click to confirm. Okay, so now we got these two here. So let's go ahead and do corner rectangle. Now I can line up right to the middle. Boom. Boom. Like that, and we can select all these. Cut in if we want. Cool. Let me control Z out there. Let's deselect that. Cool thing we can do here. You can use this trim command. Trim, boom, boom, boom. Now, let me get out of the trim command. Now we got all these nice little curves here that make up a whole shape, but it's just, they're all individual curves. Let's select them all and do J. And as you can see, all the curves turned into one curve. So now it's one continuous curve that we can move around in 3D space and do whatever we want. And of course, we can still select on them again, just like that. Cool. So other guys here is going to be your polygon. If you hold down Shift and scroll up and down, you can change the size or the amount of sides. So now we got a little hexagon there. And see, you've got your spline curve, which I don't really play with a whole lot. Execute. And you got these control points that you can manipulate the curve any way you want. So let's go regular straight line. I could do this, that, execute. And I could go to this one point right here and hit B, make a curve that way. So let me draw one more line for you. Show you another trick. Okay, you got your one single line selected or multiple lines. If you do Alt F1 or Alt 1, it says D1, it's actually Alt 1. It actually puts an extra point in there, and now you could do that. It basically turned it into this type of curve here. So, and let's see, what else can I show you? You can also do. Draw another line here. Say like I didn't have enough lines or enough points. I didn't draw enough points. I can go split curve point. And I can even do it at, say, like this intersection here because they both exist on the same plane. I do right there. And notice how the color is slightly different. It's blue. It means that these two, that this exists perfectly on that line right there. It intersects it. So that comes in handy when you're doing lofts and sweeps and stuff like that, which we'll go over in another video. So, but we could select him. Yep, there we go. And it doesn't put a curve in it. It's just another point to a line. Now, if I did a split curve point like here, since this is already kind of a curved line. Oh, see, one side of it is straight curve. So a bunch of different options here for curves and construction planes, but you can design a bunch of different little basic shapes and then extrude them out and do whatever you need to do. So, but that's basically construction lines or construction planes and a lot of your curve commands. If you want, we got the spiral here. He's kind of a three-dimensional curve here. Well, they all are, but he's kind of a interesting one. Let's see if I can get him to cooperate here. Left click. You can change the rotation, number of turns. So a bunch of different options for spiral. So that's your curves and construction planes.